What's up, you guys? This is Trips Exposing the Matrix, and I'm Trip. Today I'm going to be asking the question, is Burger King a PSYOP against the black community? I started asking myself questions like this back when I was a kid and I saw the movie Undercover Brother.
What's the word, smart brother?
I was able to decode the data from Multinational Inc. The general is under the influence of a psycho-hallucinogenic drug. It's a mind control drug, sir. Very powerful, very easy to use.
Good Lord. With something like that, the man could control every black person in America.
Theoretically, yes. But it would take years to administer the doses individually. To be efficient, you'd need to develop a huge distribution system. The chicken!
And I was reminded of this idea not that long ago whenever I saw the movie They Cloned Tyrone.
I've known this motherfucker for years. I ain't never seen him laugh. Not once. I've never seen you laugh. Yeah. I ain't seen him laugh once. Mm.
In these movies, there's usually a drug or like a powder that they're lacing the food with, but I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about more of a mind-body connection where eating certain foods will make you confused, will give you brain fog, will make you lethargic. Some of y'all may remember Burger King's Nightmare Burger, but for y'all who don't, let me give y'all a little background. The Burger King Nightmare Burger was a burger that came out around Halloween time, and it claimed that it would give you nightmares. Now, as a kid, an idea like that is very interesting, and even I was intrigued. But as an adult, I understand that what it was just crappy food that gave me indigestion and would consequentially give me nightmares. So you gotta ask yourself, if a company will give its customers indigestion on purpose, you know, just for like a little marketing ploy, what else would you put past them? To be honest, guys, if I can speak freely, Burger King sucks. I don't understand how Burger King is even open. The Burger King in my hometown never has any cars in it. So that, in combination with the fact that Burger King has always incessantly advertised towards black folks, raises my suspicions even further. I actually think that the black community is the most psyoped community in America, and I'll use hip-hop as my first example for this. Many rappers, including Meek Mill, have come out and said that they actually make more money for promoting degeneracy.
Rappers get paid to push a certain narrative.
What did Meek Mill say?
But if we get paid to rap about that stuff, they actually pay us more when we rap about more ignorant stuff, so I make sure I...
So they're told to push a certain narrative, right? Now, why would they do that? Seems like Ice Cube knows why. Recently, he was on the Club Random podcast, and this is what he said.
Same people who own the labels own the prisons. Literally the same people? Literally the same people. It seems really suspicious, if you want to say that word. The records that come out are really geared to push people towards that prison industry.
I mean, us conspiracy minds already knew, right? I did a video on this last year. And it must be well known in the industry. Listen to what Tekashi says.
I bet you there's rappers in here right now that can rap way better than me. You can rap way better than me. You will never be where I'm at because this industry is rigged. It's rigged.
And Tupac must have been presented with this information back then, because look at what he says about the future of rap. Listen.
Shit, I don't know. It depends on his balls. You know, if he's got big nuts like me, it's going to get way harder. But shit, if he's got little nuts, it's going to start getting back to a different type of rap. You know what I'm saying? Partying and f***ing and all of that type of shit. Because that's what we talk about when they don't let us talk about what we really want to talk about.
It's actually an insult to black women to say that artists like Sexy Red and Ice Spice are the best black female artists out there. That's not the case. Those are just the artists that are being pushed on the black community. This also ties into the prison industrial complex and the privatized prison systems. whenever you realize that prisons actually make more money the more prisoners that they have, you realize how messed up the system is. Before I start talking about Planned Parenthood, which would certainly send me into a rant, I'm going to show you all some videos about BHA, which is a preservative which is known to disrupt the hormones of humans, which again is like a mind-body connection. If you're disrupting the hormones of a person, you're radically changing the way that that person thinks.
Black people got an emotional attachment to this Chick-fil-A spot. I wonder what they're putting in it. And I start doing the research. You know, in the hood, there was this argument, Popeyes versus Chick-fil-A. You seen people at Popeyes, man, got shot. Man shot somebody because they didn't have no more chicken sandwiches left. I said, this ain't no regular chicken sandwiches. So I went and looked up Popeye's chicken sandwich. Come to find out, they have over 40 ingredients in the Popeye's chicken sandwich. 32 of them were man-made chemicals. And I said, well, let's see what Chick-fil-A has. Over 50 chemicals in the chicken sandwich. Over 40 of them were man-made chemicals. I said, so hell, this is a dope sandwich. They really are flipping birds over there. Because there's no way in the world to justify. I said it in a message and then went on the website of Chick-fil-A, had it broke down where they were clicking on it, showing all of these chemicals that were in it. Do you know the next day, Chick-fil-A took that down off their website? Because they don't want you to know that they're drugging you. They have you wanting the food, not for nutritional value, but because you've become addicted by the MSG and the other chemicals that they've inserted in. That also are immune system disruptors. They ill affect your brain, mess with your arteries, which means our bodies, when we eat this kind of food, they're fighting an unnecessary battle. So when the real battles of disease show up, the systems are too worn out by fighting these small battles every day from bad eating that they can't handle a virus when it shows up.
I just want to show you, this is Kellogg's Frosted Flakes, and this is Kellogg's Zucaritas. So, in the version that's not aimed at the Hispanic population, you have milled corn, sugar, malt flavor, contains 2% less of salt. And the ones that are being promoted to Hispanic population, you have milled corn, sugar, malt flavor, contains 2% less of salt, BHT. All right? Why are they doing that?
So this is up on the Environmental Working Group website, and it's talking specifically about BHA and BHT. Butylated hydroxyanisole and butylated hydroxytoluene, but these are additives that have been shown to cause hormone disruption and harm the reproductive system. And it says down here specifically about BHT that it may disrupt endocrine function by causing thyroid changes and affecting animal development, according to the European Food Safety Authority, and that studies on rats fed BHT found they developed liver and lung tumors. So this is something that is not allowed in many countries in Europe. Also, Japan banned from food. That is how dangerous other countries have acknowledged that this stuff is. They're still putting this in their products.
They can make this, okay, without that. Clearly they can. So why are they putting BHT in the one and not the other? Ask yourself.